thanks, Samir, for putting me in place. You know, I must say that. But as much as I appreciate what you said, let me put one thing straight here, that the passport project and the company MCA project, they had gone from NIC to the private sector. I'm not discussing whether it is good, for good or for bad, but it is not for the reason you are saying, for the security issues. It's not like that. I mean, there are a lot of issues which has resulted in the transition, but let that be there, and they have done a very good job. Let me appreciate also the work which has been done in the large scale project, because private sector has got a lot more resources at their disposal than the government can have at any point of time, let's be. So it is very important that we must have public sector and private sector work together.
No, my question is slightly different. I think I have not been able to explain my question well enough. I am saying is, if you go to private sector, you have gone to private sector. So don't you think at the time of handover, how will you get rid of this guy? Isn't that, should that not be a consideration?
No, no.
That if you're hiring Infosys, how will you sack them?
No, not in these two. If you are talking about these two examples, the question didn't arise because we have not handed over anything to them. The entire system was revamped. So what they did a new system. I mean, Golok can confirm my statement that they have developed. What NIC had done and the passport project was a very elementary thing, digitizing the existing system. What they have done was bringing in the workflow, which was not attempted by NIC at that time because probably the technology was not there available at that time, or maybe infrastructure was not available. When we started about 10 years before that. So when the private sector, even the MCA project, same thing. We had only digitalizing all the companies which are there and had a list. And you can just apply for it. There was no workflow when we did. We are talking about 1990s or late 90s maybe. After the technology has changed and the entire thinking the government also changed, that yes, we can give these kind of facility to the citizen, which is not necessarily only back-end computerization. What NIC did for passport as well as MCI was for back-end computerization. But let us go to the cybersecurity issue. Here also I say that it is not only government which can handle the cybersecurity issues. We have to have the private players into our domain. And not only the private player, they also can't do much. We must get the academia who should do research and bring in the new knowledge, because the attackers are always outpacing the defenders. So, chor hamesha aage bhagta hai, police piche jata hai. So, if you have to do that, we must have more researchers who will come up with technology which can predict, or maybe the artificial intelligence is bringing to some extent that learning by experience. So those kind of technology has to be brought in, and only government can never do it. We need to have others.